My name's Mike Taylor. I'm a senior partner at Hopkins Architects, and I led the design team on the London 2012 Velodrome. We looked at as many previous velodromes as possible to understand what would make this a successful venue. And so we looked at everything from first principles as to how to make the fastest track. And that was a number of things, really. First, we had to have the fastest track design, and we worked with Ron Webb, who came up with a slightly modified design for his track geometry. The track is made from 56 kilometer lengths of 40 by 40 millimeter Siberian pine. It uses 350,000 nails, all hammered in by hand to hold it in place. The banking is 42 degrees on the steep bit and 12 degrees on the shallow. We couldn't affect altitude, we couldn't compete with that, but we could modify the conditions inside to make it very fast. So we went for a venue you can make warm and thin the air down so they go faster. And we worked very hard on the atmosphere of the crowd. So we made sure there were seats all the way around and that there will be cheering all the way around the track to encourage the athletes to go as fast as possible. And then we looked very specifically at the acoustics to make that noise, give that intensity, and we brought the seats as close as we possibly could to the action. So it was intimate, very powerful. And that was something you did feel in the games, amazing noise, vibrant atmosphere, and hopefully that just pushed on all the athletes. So probably at the minute, this is the fastest track. If you could elevate it and put it at a higher altitude and thin the air out, it would be even faster. This is the track with the most records for one event. Our philosophy really was to think of the building as the house and the Olympics as the housewarming party. And so we had to make it an efficient and cheap building to run. But we wanted to capture the essence of cycling in the building. So the form of it, the feel of it, everything had to be about cycling. It's an interesting design in terms of its integration of engineering and architecture, and it was very much a team effort. The roof is a cable net roof, on top of which you have highly insulated building, so it's cheap to run, but it also uses very little material and very little embodied carbon, which is part of the sustainability story for the whole building. We brought daylight into the building, so on a day like today for training, you can ride around in natural light. Very, very good for competition, but also cheap to operate. For me, in a way, the most exciting thing will be to come back in the future on one Saturday morning and see all the kids and the future champions using this track and the other cycling facilities, and think that 2012 was a fantastic event, but somehow we've converted that energy and that focus into something for the future.